So before I started on this video, I really wanted to talk about the philosophy behind the video. One of the issues, of course, that comes up is why is the process for these not more involved? And some of these videos, of course, in a later point will have more involved process behind them, but really there's a lot of individual step-by-step large process videos existing out there already, and what there isn't a lot of are translations of tools from Maya to Softimage. So I have this feature in Softimage. What is it called? Where is it inside of Maya? And of course, dealing with things like false friends, dealing with things like we're going to deal with in this video, like groups and clusters, which sound like something that you'd be using Softimage, but behave in a really different manner inside of Maya. And then, of course, the last thing, of course, is to deal with the missing features, the things that don't exist or don't work in the way that you want them to inside of Maya at this current moment in time. And those may require a slightly more involved process, or might even require a basic script, which I will show you in these videos. Now, I really want you to know that the Autodesk team is working really hard to try and fill a lot of those gaps, and so this is really just a temporary stopgap solution where you'll have to deal with it in this current version, but as time goes on, those things will become more comfortable and most of those things will be filled in. So let's get started on the basics of this video, which is dealing with layers, groups, sets, and clusters. So layers I wanted to start with because it's the most direct translation, really. This layer mode here is really quite similar to the one that you can find under the this panel right here, where you just go ahead and add the objects to a layer, and it works fairly close to the same way that that one does. So of course, if I grab a bunch of objects and I click on this one, you can see it adds them all to that group. Of course, I can create empty groups and I can move the layers up and down. If I create a couple more layers here, I can take these layers and move them using my middle mouse button to change the order of them. I'm just going to go ahead, right click, and delete that layer there. You can also grab other items and then right click and add them to the group, so add selected objects to that group, and of course you can remove selected items from that group. So the group here, simply click on it, we have visibility, click on this guy, goes into template mode, which is basically wireframe without selectability, reference mode, which is currently visible but again not selectable, and we have this guy next to it. Double click on that, brings up our edit layer options, which shows the current display type, the visibility, which are these two buttons right there. And of course, this slash thing is basically saying that there's no color assigned to it. If I pick a color, I can also write in a name and do that. What this means is if I press 4 on the keyboard, that's going to be the wireframe color. So this is basically it right here. So if I just change that to, I don't know, that, you'll see that the color will change. Now, a layer has a singular membership, so I can't add this item to multiple other layers. If I were to create another layer and grab these two items, add those selected, and add the selected items. There we go. This one object is affected, but these guys are not because they've been added to a separate layer. You have, of course, your other layer options here, and then anything relating to the right click. It's got options for all sorts of stuff in here as well that you can peek through. Most of them are pretty straightforward. So that's basics of layers in a nutshell. If I go ahead and delete this layer, even though there's items in the layer currently, it doesn't delete the items inside the layer. It simply just deletes the layer and sets them back to the world. So let's move on to the next thing, which would be groups. If I go ahead and grab these guys and press Control G, or go up to Edit Group, I get a group from there. And really all this is, if we open up the outliner, is essentially a transform node basically like an object without anything in it, or kind of like a null without any visible null properties to it. And they're all parented underneath it. So they're basically just children of this transform node. And really that's all there is to it. And because it's a basic hierarchy, it means again that unlike the groups inside of Softimage, where this cube could exist in multiple different groups inside of Maya, because it's just a parent-child relationship, it can only be assigned to one. So the group really isn't anything major, it's just a simple transform node. I could press Control H to deal with visibility, Shift H to unhide, and just deal with general visibility of that item. Whereas in, of course, in Softimage, I can go ahead and change render visibility, view visibility, etc. on these guys, which is not the case with groups here. So that's the first thing to note. I can ungroup it, and I've created myself a hotkey for this, which I would highly recommend, which is just Control Shift G. And I'm just going to ungroup that, which basically deletes the group and unparents the items. So sets. Sets are probably the closest to groups that you can get inside of Maya. So if we go ahead and create sets, and we've got set or quick select set, which is my more favorite one. Just go to quick select set, and you have the option of giving the set a name. And then of course you can add it to the shelf as I've done here, which are quick selection methods. Otherwise you go over top of them, just cancel that. And you select set members, and that will select all the members of that set. And of course, you'll see them here. And these items can exist in multiple sets. So just like groups, this cube could be in like 12 different sets, and nothing is lost there. Unfortunately, with the sets, we don't really have any options here for dealing with sets being renderable or not renderable. Once you select a set, you can of course go ahead and select the set and change its visibility, but not its renderability easily. So this is where a script is going to come in. I will just show you in the attribute editor these items here, and I've just opened it up to their render stats, where our primary visibility would be. And I've just created two little scripts here based off of doing a quick select set. So if I click this one, you can see the primary visibility is turning on and off. And of course, I did another one here just for fun, which is basically just a show and hide toggle using the same script with a slight variation. So the option here is that when you create a set onto the shelf, it automatically gives you this, which is the selection, replace the current selection with the members of that set. And then what I've added here is this additional portion, which is basically creating a string, and this is called selected for the value, and it's putting the selection list in there. And then for each element in that selection, it's going to pass it on to the node value, where it's going to go ahead and change its visibility and then turn that into the inverse of it, so not whatever that value currently is. And then of course for the other option, it would be primary capital V would be your primary visibility. And then of course you do the same thing here. Primary all lowercase capital V for visibility, and that would deal with the primary visibility, turning it on and off. So if you really needed the buttons for that, you could go ahead and do that. This would actually work for any selection. I'm making a single button to basically select the set as well as doing this function, but you could instead just have a visibility toggle and a renderability toggle for anything that you currently have selected, just quickly by using this portion of the script as opposed to the rest of it here. So moving right along, just close that, and let's deal with the last guy here, which is going to be clusters, which again will not work quite the same as you expect them inside of Softimage. And that simply is grabbing a selection of items, whatever they may be. They can be applied to objects or components. Under animation, create deformers, cluster. Now what's important here is to understand where it's being stored, which is the create deformers. This is essentially a deformer object, much like you would have for a joint, which has been given assignment to these specific points. It's got a membership. And really it's just a handle and space where you grab these things and move them around. You can also do weighting of this particular item. So under edit deformers, you can paint the cluster weights just the same as you would paint any other deformer. You can also adjust their current membership and add or remove items from them, so using something like the membership tool. So let's take a look at that. So let's first create it. Cluster. I've got a few options here, whether it's relative or not, which relates to if it's relative to its parent, or if you end up with things like double transforms if it's not relative in that particular case. The envelope value, how much it controls this over something else. And of course, under the advanced, because it is a deformer, it has a deformer order, in which case you need to consider whether or not this is a skinned object or it has other things like blend shapes, etc., which will determine whether or not you want to set it to before, after, etc. So I'm just going to use the default settings here, create a cluster, and it creates this tiny little C. And that C, of course, can then be moved around, and it's basically just a handle. So with it selected, I'm going to go to Edit Deformers and Edit Membership, and it's going to highlight all these things. I'm just going to hold down Shift, add these things to it. If I were to drag through, remember that you're going to drag through the other side. Use Control to then remove from that selection. There we go. And that's pretty much it. Those have been now added to that selection, so you can edit the membership in that way. Then of course, the Paint Cluster Weights tool, go to the option box. You should have the ability to paint that, but of course this is going to be on this object. So not with a cluster selected, but the object that it's applied to. And then we go into this tool, and you can see the weighting for that. And it's really just a matter of holding down your B key to change your brush size. You could use Control to remove, basically doing the invert function, similar to what you'd be doing in other software. Holding down Shift will, of course, smooth that out, so you can smooth out those features. Or you can just go ahead and directly add, and that's all with the Replace currently turned on. So you really don't have to change options very much. So I can smooth that off and get a nice, more even transition. And then when I'm done, I just simply go ahead and deal with selecting that directly. Move that around and you see it's a smoother movement of that. Additionally, I can grab this object and go to Window General Editors, Component Editor. I bring that over. And we have the points which would be assigned to this. So I'm just going to grab those components first of all. Highlight those. And in the weighted deformer, you'll see cluster one is listed there. And you've got the ones that it's been assigned to. And anything that hasn't been assigned to won't really show up. So those are your cluster values there. Now, last but not least, course, is I'm just going to go quickly back into that weight painting thing, and note that you have a filter here which basically allows you to pick what stuff it's assigned to, which cluster that you're dealing with the painting for. So if you have multiple clusters on your object, those things will be available to pick from which ones you want, and of course just simply flooding. So that's the basic of what a cluster is, what a group is, as far as Maya is concerned. So those are major differences for you. And of course, dealing with sets to make up for your loss of groups and the idea of adding some simple scripts to that. So hopefully this has been a helpful video, and that's all I got.